Rockefeller Center is located in Midtown Manhattan. It is bounded on the east by Fifth Avenue, on the west by Avenue of the Americas or Sixth Avenue, on the south by 48th Street, and on the north by 51st Street. It was the brainchild of John D. Rockefeller Jr., who built it almost entirely with his own money. It is a combination of classic and modern design. It was planned as a city of the future. Well, here we get a closer look at Rockefeller Center, and here are the original buildings in this rectangle. This building and these four buildings here on 6th Avenue were added in the 1960s and 70s. While technically a part of Rockefeller Center, they are sorry neighbors to the elegance of the original buildings, and we will not be visiting them. Abby Rockefeller, John D. Jr.'s wife and one of the founders of the Museum of Modern Art, is responsible for all of the art we will see. And what we will see is a fraction of the art at the center. Rockefeller Center is considered the greatest urban complex of the 20th century. 14 buildings were constructed between 1931 and 1939. It is a masterpiece of the Art Deco style in limestone, glass, and bronze. Well, here we are at what may be considered the main entrance to Rockefeller Center. We see the French building on the left and the British Empire building on the right, and in the center, the aptly named Channel Gardens. And a closer view of the Channel Gardens with the fountains and the sculptures. Not very colorful this time of the year, but spectacular in the spring and summer, fall. The Channel Gardens is the first public botanical garden in the nation. Proceeding down the path to the skating rink. Well, here we see 30 Rock, the tallest building in the complex, about 70 stories. Well, here we see the skating rink, the statue of Prometheus, and 30 Rockefeller Plaza behind it. The Rainbow Room atop 30 Rock was once the most famous restaurant in New York. Today it's only open for special events. Now there's Prometheus, probably one of the most photographed sculptures in the city, if not the country. And right above Prometheus is where the Christmas tree appears every December, and it's been appearing since 1931. Christmas Day in 1936. It was supposed to be temporary, but it's still here today.
The big idea was to pull everything away.
Well, here's the main entrance to 30 Rockefeller Plaza, and we can see the sculpture of Zeus above the revolving doors. The sculptured glass below Zeus is called Sands and Light. Now here we are inside of 30 Rockefeller Plaza, and this is one of the few landmarked interiors in the city. The murals adorning the walls and ceiling are by Jose Maria Sert. They're in a classical style with modern imagery. Notice the black terrazzo floor. Radiators are within the columns. Well, here we are at 1250 Avenue of the Americas. And just above the main entrance are sculptures entitled Aspects of Mankind. Just above the revolving doors are the mosaic tiles of Barry Faulkner, the artist, from 1933. The title of this work is Intelligence Awakening Mankind. Above the entrance to 1270 Avenue of the Americas are three sculptures. They are titled Morning, Present, Evening. And this was the first work of art commissioned for Rockefeller Center. And it set the stage for the Art Deco style of the complex. Now the first building to be completed at Rockefeller Center is at 1260 Avenue of the Americas. Within is the Radio City Music Hall. At 6,000 seats, it is the largest in the country and the most famous. The stainless steel and aluminum marquee distinguish it from the rest of Rockefeller Center, where only limestone, glass, and bronze were used. The Music Hall opened in 1932. Samuel Roxy Rutherford brought his Roxyettes to the Music Hall soon after. When Rutherford left for other ventures, the Roxyettes became the Rockettes, and they're still here. Above the marquee of the Music Hall, we see three sculptures by Hildred Meriere, titled Dance, Drama, and Song. Well, this is 50 Rockefeller Plaza. Above the main entrance is a Isamu Noguchi sculpture entitled News. It is his only work in steel. Notice the typewriter and the notepad. This is because this was the home of the Associated Press for many years. In front of 630 Fifth Avenue is Atlas. It was installed in 1937. It depicts the Greek Titan Atlas holding the heavens on his shoulders. The sculptor is by Lee Laurie. who's one of the most important architectural sculptors prior to World War II. He's a true icon of the Art Deco style. Well, here's the lobby of 630 Fifth Avenue, a beautiful interior space. And we see the sculptures on the wall called Light and Movement by Michio Ihara. And we can see the copper ceiling. Above 19 West 50th Street is another Lee Laurie sculpture called Swords into Plowshares. At 29 West 50th, another Lee Laurie sculpture, The Story of Mankind.
The grind just starts.
And at 9 West 50th Street, we see another Lee Laurie, St. Francis of Assisi with Birds. At 10 West 51st, we see Cornucopia of Plenty, another Lee Laurie sculpture. Well, here we are in 10 Rockefeller Plaza with this mural spanning three walls of the lobby. The work is titled The History of Transportation. It's by Dean Cornwell. Well, we're at 610 Fifth Avenue, also known as the French Building or La Maison Française. Above the entrance are two sculptures by Alfred Genoy. The first is Friendship Between America and France, and above it is Liberty, Equality, Fraternity. Well, here at the entrance of the French Building is Lee Laurie once again. Seeds of Good Citizenship. Above an entrance to 620 Fifth Avenue is Winged Mercury. Well, here at 620, the British Empire Building, we see Industries of the British Empire by Carl Genuin. There's much more art to see, so why not visit Rockefeller Center?